Welcome to Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Vidya Alankar Institute of Technology. In this department, we have taken this new initiative to start our own YouTube channel. In this YouTube channel, we are going to upload all our experiments video, value-added course video, or any other important videos. This material will be available to all the students in Mumbai University, and this material will help students to enhance their learning, not just in their classroom, but even outside the classroom. I hope that everyone will like this our effort, and in case of any query, comments, anything, they can put it in comment box. Thank you.
Hello everyone, welcome to Communication Engineering Lab 1. Today we are going to perform experiment number 2, that is study and analysis of pulse modulation, in which we will be covering pulse amplitude modulation and demodulation, pulse width modulation and demodulation, pulse position modulation and demodulation. Let's begin with pulse amplitude modulation. In pulse amplitude modulation, a pulse signal is used to sample an analog signal. The amplitude of each pulse is proportional to the amplitude of the message signal at the time of sampling. The pulse carrier can be modulated in amplitude and in the time. Okay, so now let us see the connections for PAM on the trainer kit. For this experiment, we need the pulse amplitude modulation and demodulation trainer kit, DSO, BNC wires and patch cords. So now let us begin with the connection. In this, we have given a 32 kHz pulse pulse wave to as an input to the pulse in knob over here, and we are giving a sine wave of 1 kHz frequency as it's the modulating signal, and we are checking the output as the sample output over here on the channel 2, and on channel 1 we are checking the pulse input. So now let us see the output on the DSO. As you can see on the output, you can see that this is the sampled version of the input sine wave. This is the input sine wave which you have given. To check the input pulse signal, you just need to remove this knob from here and see the pulse input. Okay, so now for checking the pulse input, we'll just connect this to the pulse input. This is our channel 1. So now let's observe the waveform at the output. At the output, you can see on the channel 1, you can see the pulse input. At the channel 2, you should get the sampled output. If you are not getting the proper waveform, you need to just auto set and you can scale it as per required. Once you get the sine wave, just stop it and you can see the sampled version. Now you can see the pulse input over here and you can see the sample output over here. So now let us see the demodulation for PAM. Okay, so now for demodulation, we have to connect the sample output to as input to the low pass filter, and we have to check the demodulated output at the output of low pass filter. We'll connect channel 2 over here, and channel 1 is we'll keep it as the sample output, so as to observe that the demodulated output from the sampled version is observed on the DSO. So now let us check the output. Now you can see that this is the sampled version on the channel 1, and we are getting the demodulated output on channel 2. If you just scale it up, you can see that this is the sampled version and this is the demodulated version. Now here you will observe that this wave and this wave, in this wave and in both the wave, there is a little bit delay, which is the delay for the circuit to go from the modulation to the demodulation. Similarly, you can perform the experiments for PWM and PPM and observe the output on the DSO. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.